Radio Online.
Yo, this is the furthest we can go. As you can see, shops are being looted and being burnt. It's quite hectic. We've been told that if we don't move, we could actually get hurt. This is Corner Lille Ngoye and what street? Just behind Bloed Mall in Pretoria. Struben and Corner Lille Ngoye. Situation is quite turmoil. Angry, violent protesters here as well, throwing rocks and burning tires.
The question arises, and we must investigate also what is the law of South Africa says. How can a city in South Africa be 80% foreign nationals? That is dangerous. That in Hillbrow and the surrounding areas, South Africans have surrendered their own city to the foreign nationals. The nation should discuss that particular question. You won't find South
Men, the women of our country are feeling so insecure, and rightly so. They are feeling that their lives are not well regarded and respected in our country. We cannot have a situation like that where women in our country have a sense of security. So we will be redoubling the efforts that we are making, and the gender-based summit declaration and decisions are now going to have to be acted upon with greater speed and with greater determination. And our criminal justice system must now gear up to make sure that the perpetrators of these acts are actually brought to book and they are sentenced and they serve long sentences in prison, so that every man who is tempted to take action against any woman must know that there are going to be stiff sentences against them and they will serve time in prison, because this is unacceptable. We cannot have a situation like this. At the same time, it was with a great deal of relief that Emily Diaga, the young girl who was kidnapped, was returned safely to her home. We're delighted about that. But there is an issue of concern that we must also highlight, that women and young girls are being targeted for all manner of horrible deeds, like kidnapping, like being abused, and violence being perpetrated against them. Now, the kidnapping specter is what concerns me most. And we must tell the whole nation that those who want to kidnap people are going to face the full might of the law. We cannot allow kidnapping type of things to happen in South Africa. We often hear about them in other countries. We cannot allow them here. So our security forces are going to be on full alert, make sure that those who get involved in these types of acts are followed up, as they should be followed up now in this Emily. Now, I'd like to condemn the violence that has been spreading around a number of provinces in our country in the strongest terms. The attacks on people who run businesses from foreign nationals, it's something that's totally unacceptable. It's something that we cannot allow to happen in South Africa, where people who are running their own businesses are attacked and their businesses are destroyed through looting and being firebombed, something that is completely against the ethos that we as South Africans espouse. And there can be no justification whatsoever about what people are having a grievance over, that they should go out and attack people from other countries. Because when they do so here, they should also know that fellow South Africans will be attacked in other countries. We are a country that is completely committed against xenophobia. We do not allow and cannot tolerate the attacks on people from other African countries, and indeed from other countries completely. So these attacks are completely against the rule of law. And I'd like to commend the security forces, particularly the police, for stopping further violence from ensuing in a number of places, in KZN, as well as in Gauteng. And we want our security forces to carry on with the work that they've been doing, arresting the perpetrators, ensuring that these violent acts do not continue. I'm going to be convening the ministers in the security cluster today to make sure that we keep a very close eye on all these acts of wanton violence and find ways of stopping them. I've directed the Minister of Police to have a meeting at the hostels with the Indunas, because this violence is now mutating and taking different forms that represent themselves in a way that we do not want to see in South Africa, where communities are seen to be attacking one another. So we want this to stop, and I want it to stop immediately. The people of our country want to live in harmony, and whatever grievance and concerns that people have, we need to handle it in a democratic way. We need to handle it by discussing concerns and problems that we may have. And we've done so very well in the past on a number of other very difficult issues. And this is precisely what we should continue doing. So there is just no justification whatsoever for any South African to go out of their way to attack people from other countries. We need to act in a way where we give respect to people from other countries and show them that they are welcome to be in our country. We need to deal with our own problems in a way where we sit down and discuss those issues with the various structures that we have. We cannot accept a sense that South Africans do not welcome Africans or other people from other countries. We cannot do that, because we are welcomed in other countries. Right now, we are part of the whole continent having inaugurated the Africa Free Trade Area Agreement. So our drivers are now going to be afraid to drive vehicles in other countries. And there's just no justification whatsoever for people who have a sense that their jobs are being taken by people from foreign lands to attack them, to destroy properties, and actually to kill them. This must be stopped. And this is a national crisis. Gender-based violence in South Africa has become a huge crisis. And it's something that we've got to address. Now, we've been horrified by the killing of Uyinene Mkhwetjana, recently a student at the University of Cape Town, who went to a post office and was brutally murdered. And what concerns me more, of course, is that it happens in a government entity and a government employee. That is a matter of real deep concern to me. But at the same time, we've had Leandre Jechels, who was also murdered. And these are acts of killings against women that we cannot accept. I've spoken extensively about this matter. And following the gender-based violence summit that we had, we are making progress on a number of fronts. But it does seem like the men of our country, South Africa, are continuing with the killing of women. The respect that I've always said that we should display towards women is just not gaining traction. Now I'm calling upon the men of South Africa to stand up one by one and declare that We've got to bring an end to the scourge of the killing of young women and women in our country. It's got to end. Gender-based violence is a scourge that is not acceptable in a democratic dispensation. We've got to increase safety for women in our country. And we've got, as men, to ensure that we give respect and due regard to the women of our country. And we will be doing everything we can from the criminal justice system to make sure that we increase the level of protection